Belfast High School Carol Service. You are all most, most welcome this evening.
It is particularly nice to see members of staff, former members of staff, former pupils back with us this evening. And I hope that you will find this evening's service just as enjoyable as those that you remember fondly when you were with us at the school. Before I start, however, I would like to say a word of public thanks to all those who have contributed in any way to this evening's service. I think it's important that we recognise that a huge amount of effort has gone on behind the scenes to prepare for this evening. I would also take a moment to ask you to just check where the closest fire exit is to you and to make sure that for the duration of the service that your mobile phone is switched off or is in airplane mode. There will also be a retiring collection this evening for one of the charities that we are dedicating a lot of our fundraising to this year, and that is to the Northern Ireland Children's Hospice. So we will have some members of our community services team standing at the doors on your way out, and they will be only too happy to receive any donations that you feel you are in a position to give. I also hope that as many of you as possible will be able to remain behind and to join us for a cup of tea after the service in the church hall. Our service will now proceed with no further announcements. And can I ask two things? Number one, can we start off by giving all those who are involved a round of applause at this stage? Thank you. And then can I ask, as this is a carol service, that I ask that we refrain from any further applause until we reach the end of the service. Thank you very much indeed. Let us pray. Father God, we come together this evening, each one of us a member of the Belfast High School family. We are here tonight to celebrate the hope and the joy of Christmas in the presence of you, our Father. In our service, we will hear and receive the good news of the birth of Christ, and we offer to God our thanksgiving through our own joyful singing of the carols. As we gather together tonight, once again in person, we gather, as always, in the name of Christ. And we pray today for the world that he came to save. We pray for the church, that it may be enabled to live out the good news of God's love to a needy world. We pray for everyone across God's world, that all of the people may recognize their responsibility for its future, and may be inspired by the message of Christmas to work together for justice, freedom, peace, and compassion everywhere. We pray also tonight for those who are in particular individual need. We pray for the sick, the anxious, the lonely, the fearful, and the bereaved, that the peace and light of the Christ child may bring hope and healing to all who sit in darkness. And finally, Father God, we pray for our own school community, that God's love surrounds everyone, not only at this special time of year when we celebrate his earthly birth, but every day and every year from henceforth. We ask all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
This Christmas time, consider well and bear. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. Then the Lord God called to Adam and said to him, "Where are you?" So he said, "I heard your voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you that you should not eat?" Then the man said, "The woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I ate." And the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent deceived me, and I ate." So the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you are cursed more than all cattle, and more than every beast of the field. On your belly you shall go, and you shall eat dust all the days of your life. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel." Then to Adam he said, "Because you have heeded the voice of your wife, and have eaten from the tree of which I commanded you, saying, 'You shall not eat of it,' cursed is the ground for your sake. In toil you shall eat of it. All the days of your life, both thorns and thistles it shall bring forth for you, and you shall eat the herb of the field. In the sweat of your face you shall eat bread, till you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken, for dust you are, and to dust you shall return." Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Then the angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time out of heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this thing and have not withheld your son, your only son, blessing, I will bless you, and multiplying, I will multiply your descendants as the stars of the heaven and as the sand which is on the seashore. And your descendants shall possess the gate of their enemies. In your seed, all the nations of the earth shall be blessed, because you have obeyed my voice." Thanks be to God.
Thank you. people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of the shadow of death, upon them a light has shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there will be no end. Upon the throne of David and over his kingdom, to order it and establish it with judgment and justice from that time forward, even forever, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. There shall come forth a rod from the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. The wolf also shall dwell with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the young goat, the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young ones shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play by the cobra's den, and the weaned child shall put his hand in the viper's den. They shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And having come in, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, highly favoured one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." But when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favour with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and shall call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Then Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I do not know a man?" And the angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Therefore also that Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God." Then Mary said, "Behold the maidservant of the Lord, let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the world would be registered. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days that were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Thanks be to God.
Light, warm, heavy, as pure as gold, and the angels sing softly to the newborn babe.
Thank you. Now there were, in the same country, shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Saviour, who is Christ the Lord, and this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." So it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. us to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord. Oh,
Now, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born the King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. So they said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, 'But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people, Israel.'" Then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men, determined from them what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the young child. And when you have found him, bring back word to me, that I may come and worship him also." When they heard the king, they departed, and behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then, being divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed for their own country another way. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. that star. Dum dum da 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 da.
They had to find a little town. They had to find a little town. It was not easy to be found.
Follow that star.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him nothing was made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. This man came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which gives light to every man coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own did not receive him. But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, to those who believe in his name, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.
May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with each and every one of us, tonight and forevermore. Amen. Now, ladies and gentlemen, all that remains for me to do is two things. First of all, it is to wish you an extremely happy, safe and blessed Christmas on behalf of everyone in Belfast High School. And secondly, I don't know about you, but this has just been a very special evening, and it's made all the more special because we have been denied this opportunity for the last 2 years. So can I ask us to show our appreciation to what we have heard this evening? Thank you very much. A beautiful, beautiful evening, and there was just magical voices, whether it was the spoken word from the Bible or the sung word from the congregation and from our special choirs and to our orchestras and our junior strings. Thank you very much indeed, every single one of you. So that's us now. Our service is complete for 2022. Safe home, everyone, if you can't stay, but we would love to catch up with all of you just through these doors or out through the main doors at the back and then into the hall. And please don't forget our retiring offering this evening in aid of the Northern Ireland Children's Hospice. Merry Christmas, everybody. Stay safe, take care, safe home. Thank you.